Happy New Year 2022, although it's not as happy as it should be because I just received word from AT&T, the wireless carrier that covers my area, that they are discontinuing the 3G service, which means my Motorola RAZR is not going to work anymore. This has been my trusted cell phone since 2007, and a lot of people laugh because I use a pager still also, and they're, oh, pager, yeah, ha, ha, that. Well, this still works, and this is going to continue working according to the carrier. But unfortunately, my trusty Motorola RAZR is not going to work anymore in a few more days or maybe a week or two. This has been absolutely the best cell phone I've ever had. And of course, my first cell phone I ever had that I could carry around was this StarTAC here, which is kind of fun for making calls, kind of space age-like. But then sometime in, I think, 2003, we moved and Verizon didn't cover this area. So I got this phone, which was my first Motorola RAZR back in 03. And this one still worked until they discontinued the 2G service. But this one that I got in 2007, this has been fantastic. These phones have great audio quality. They have great coverage performance because the antenna being located here, when you're talking, the antenna is vertical. It's away from you. And it just had, I don't know, had a reception in places that the other phones didn't. The battery on this thing lasts like a whole week or more between charges. That's a battery. This thing has been fantastic. I loved it. In fact, my very first YouTube videos were recorded on that camera right there. And if you go back at my very first videos, people were complaining that it looked like I recorded it on a potato. Well, there's the potato. Absolutely have loved this phone, and it has served me well for, I don't know, forever. And unfortunately, now it's not going to work anymore, they say. So I want to give it one more shot. Although this will receive and send text messages, it's kind of hard because you have to type, you know, for Q, you have to hit that, you know, four times, and it sending sucks. But you can receive text messages. You can get notifications. You could even surf the web on these. It had a rudimentary web browser, which is kind of cool. So I just want to give it one more quick phone call just for old time's sake before AT&T takes this away from me. I'm going to make a crank phone call. So here we go. Hey, Model T.
What?
Hey, is your Model A running?
Yes.
You better go catch it! Although nowhere near as fancy or feature-rich as a modern smartphone, these did have quite a few things that were pretty ahead of their time. Taking a picture, for example, you just click here and wait for the phone part to boot up, and there you go. You can take your picture and done. Picture. You could save them, you could share them, you could send it to a friend by hitting send. Send to, and then just pick somebody from your phone book, or if you wanted to, you could abort the message. Just get out of that. We could go to, you know, it had Bluetooth, even a music player. You could do mobile email. You could change audio as for changing your ringtone. Your wallpaper, obviously, is the background on the screen. You could shop for ringtones. This was really ahead of its time. And dial singular, this is the carrier's name before AT&T took it over. Now, getting out of that, going to the main menu here, Singular Video was kind of a rudimentary video service, not quite like you see now with YouTube or something, but you could watch some pretty simple videos on it. The messaging is just plain old text messaging. If you wanted to look at your voicemail box, you could do that too, right here. And MediaNet was kind of their introduction to the internet, but for these phones, unfortunately, it's been offline for many, many years. Yes, I'll exit the browser. So the Singular Mall was for shopping online through these phones, which was way ahead of its time. Singular Music, again, a music service like MP3s you could load for your phone, either just to listen to them with the headphones, which you would plug in right here, or you could just listen through the speaker. And then My Stuff, which is funny because it actually has built-in games. There were some pretty simple rudimentary games. Keep in mind, no touchscreen on this, so you have to use the up, down, left, right arrows and the middle button to do everything on the screen. It wasn't exactly intuitive, but it wasn't difficult either. For 2007, to be able to do this on the go, from your car, in your hand, it fits in your pocket, was absolutely ahead of its time. There is something so satisfying about being able to go when you're done with a phone call, like, no, I do not need an extended automotive warranty. It just feels good. You can't do that with an iPhone. You break the screen or whatever. For 15 years, I've been carrying this phone, and it's been solid, reliable, and now, because of the 3G shutdown, according to this message here, that's it. I'm done. Nothing you can do. Doesn't matter. I pay your bill every month. So what? You're gone. Whatever. So if you have a cell phone that you really like and you're not going to be able to use it after the 3G shutdown, I feel your pain. Happy New Year. Technology, right?
So it looks like I got to upgrade whether I want to or not. All right. Whatever.